This lecture on the relationship between Muslims and non-Muslims is given by Sheikh Dr. Muhammad Basem Dahman. In the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful, all praise be to God and peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad, the last of prophets and messengers, his father Abraham, and his brothers Moses and Jesus. Peace be upon them all, and those who follow their example till the judgment day. We want to clarify a very important issue, which is the relationship of Muslims with Jews, Christians, and all other religions. Are Muslims really like what the enemies of Islam portray? Are they like what the enemies of humanity claim? Those enemies of humanity, those arms dealers, they do not want peace in the world, so they seek
ولا بد
wars and destruction.
يشعل الأرض بمن فيها.
They distort the image of Islam, so they say that Islam wants to kill every Jew just because he's a Jew, or that Islam wants to kill every Christian just because he's a Christian.
وأتى ليقتل كل مسيحي فقط لأنه مسيحي.
This is completely a false and just claim.
وفيه ظلم وفيه إفك وفيه باطل فإن
الإسلام
لم
did not come to kill. Islam aims at building both men
أتى ليبني الأرض
أتى Islam aims at teaching people faith and how to live in this world.
فالنبي
محمد,
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
peace be upon him started his mission in
Mecca.
One of the first people who believed in him was a Christian priest called Waraqa bin Nawfal. When Prophet Muhammad told this priest about what happened in the cave of Hira, when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, received his first revelation from God through the angel Gabriel, this priest said, it is the same revelations to Moses and Jesus. And then he said, I wish I were young and strong so that I could help you when your people drive you out of your home. When Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, moved to Medina and established a state there, most of the people there were pagan. They believed in Islam and they supported the Prophet and chose him to be their leader. He was their leader and guide in faith and the world. The first thing that the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, did was forming a pact with the Jews, who were almost a third of the population in Medina. They lived in independent neighborhoods around Medina. They came from three tribes.
أو وضع وثيقة بينه وبينه هذه الوثيقة مختصرة
This fact is available verbatim in history books
لبنودها في كتب التاريخ مختصرها
It states that Jews and Muslims are brothers and they are equal in duties and rights
فإخوة في كل شيء
socially, economically, and in faith.
ما على المسلمين من حقوق مدنية وحقوق اقتصادية وحقوق دينية وحقوق كاملة اجتماعية كاملة بل وكان بينه وبين
They had also a defense pact.
دفاع مشترك وبينه وبين اليهود أمور أخرى تفصيلية في قضايا القتل الخطأ وغير ذلك فكل بنود
Very briefly,
هذه المعاهدة
This pact guarantees the equality of rights and duties. But Jews in Medina violated this pact.
يخونون هذا العهد بدأوا ينقضون هذا العهد نقضوه
many times.
مرتين وثلاث مرات
So the prophet
وهو قائد أمة وهو
who formed this pact with them
عهدا وفيه شروط وفيه
and was a leader of this nation and they accepted all provisions voluntarily and by free choice made them leave Medina because of their violations they were citizens but they conspired with the Romans who occupied Levant and with Arabs who were pagan. They laid a siege to Medina. And gathered almost 10,000 Arab fighters. At the end, they ended this siege because it had no effect. After that, and only after that, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, sentenced those who betrayed their homeland and violated the pact, those who conspired with the enemies of the homeland and the country and the nation, to death. This judgment is common in the world for those who betray their homeland and conspire with enemies, for those who commit high treason. Verses describing Jews and their treason were revealed. They had a history of treason. They harmed Moses, peace be upon him, and he was their prophet. They also harmed prophets. You can see that in Torah. When Muslims have a negative attitude towards Jews, it's not because they are Jews. It is because they violate pacts. Today, they came to Palestine. As you all know, they made an agreement with Britain to establish a safe home for the Jews. They gathered them from all countries of the world. Had they come to live in the land where the revelation to Moses took place, Muslims would have said, "You are welcome." But they came to control this land and Judaize this land by establishing a state at the expense of Arabs and Muslims who have this land. They came to wage a war against Islam. They didn't come to live with Muslims. That's why Muslims today say that we should liberate Palestine because Jews occupy Palestine. Most of the Jews in Palestine are from European countries, Africa and other countries. They are not the sons of this land. Even secular laws in all over the world do not accept that people from a land move into another land, then control it by establishing a state at the expense of the original people.
ديانتها
and their faith. Neither reason, morals, religions, nor positive laws accept that Muslims do not fight Jews because they are Jews. It is because they occupy this land and because they wage a war against Islam. They want to obliterate the Islamic culture, Islam, and the Arabic identity of Palestine. For those reasons, we stand against Jews. We don't want the two-state solution. It is unjust, even if they give Jerusalem to Muslims. If the Jews want to live in Palestine, they live as citizens, with or without naturalization. What is important is that they are citizens, but the land owners have the right to govern their land. So they live as guests. This is the solution, but they didn't come for that. They have a plot since 1917, and they try to take a big step in this plot by declaring Jerusalem as their capital.
هي عاصمة الثالثة في الإسلام هي المدينة الثالثة في الأهمية في بلاد المسلمين وهي عاصمة هذه الأرض التي يقال لها فلسطين والتي هي جزء من بلاد الشام والتي جزأها سايكس بيكو كما هو معروف في التاريخ إلى دويلات إذن
Muslims do not fight Christianity. Muslims do not fight Jews. When the Crusaders occupied Palestine and the shores of Levant, Muslims fought them not because they are Christian. The Christians of Palestine, Jerusalem, and Levant fought with the army of Saladin against this ferocious crusade. We call them crusades not because of contempting the cross or because they took the cross as their symbol, rather because they themselves call it so, crusade. They wage this religious war against Muslims to obliterate Islam in these sacred land. The Church of the Holy Sepulchre has its best days and it is well taken care of in the Islamic states. Go to Levant, go to Damascus, Aleppo, and Lebanon. All the churches in Levant that were built by followers of Jesus still stand today and they are always renovated and they have supervisors and special organizations with absolute freedom of faith. Churches, bells ring publicly. This is the Islamic history, and there is no problem in that. For you is your religion, for me is my religion. Islam didn't come to fight other religions. Islam is a call for the last message. For you is your religion and for me is my religion. And to say to people, there is no compulsion in religion. This is the main rule in Islam. Muslims live with non-Muslims together and they have even more rights than the rights of Muslims with each other. You can see that in the Islamic Sharia books. So these are false accusations, fabricated lies, just to keep. So these are false accusations, fabricated lies, just to keep wars standing in the world. And they think that the best areas for these wars are Muslim areas and these sacred lands. Jews wants to control this land. The world should know that Muslims do not fight for the sake of war, but they fight defending themselves and their homelands. Muslims defend their faith and culture. This is a legal right in all cultures and countries. This is a legal right for every man and every country, for every group of people. They have right to choose whatever faith they want. They have right to defend it. They have right to use weapons when they are attacked with weapons. This is what we believe in. Islam is a call for peace, not for war. But the countries who have greedy ambitions in Muslim lands, they start wars, and Muslims should face these wars. This is the truth. And we hope that the world see it. Praise be to God.